What's going on, everybody? It's the Hook Cam back again with another film breakdown. A video that I've been getting a lot of requests to do actually is a What's Wrong with the Cleveland Browns. I took a little bit of time. They're on their bye week this week. I checked out what has been going wrong with the last 2 weeks of their film, looking at their game against the Seahawks and then their game against the Niners. So with all that being said, guys, I would really appreciate if you could like and subscribe. It's really helping the channel grow. Just really quickly, I'm not making this video because I hate Cleveland or anything like that. I actually am a big Baker fan. I really want to see the Browns do well this year, so it's been kind of disappointing for me as well. But the Browns have there's positives. There's definitely positives. In this video, I just kind of try and take the film that I see, put my coaching perspective into it, and then really make it into a video. See if I can shed some light on things for some fans who really don't know the game. So, with all that being said, guys, I hope that you enjoy, and let's jump on into this thing. All right, fellas, taking a look at what's going on with the Cleveland Browns. Going back to this 49er game was on Monday Night Football a couple weeks ago. Early in the first quarter, Baker throws a pick. And what we're going to look at here is kind of what goes wrong with it and what I believe he saw. So, for starters, he's going to motion in the tight end into the formation. Okay, now protection-wise, this is going to really bug me. This is one of my biggest bugaboos about the NFL right now, is the fact that they bring tight ends in to block in the formation, and then they just leave them one-on-one with an edge defender, right? Whether it's a defensive end, whether it's a pass rushing linebacker, it doesn't matter. They just leave them one-on-one. This is a recipe for disaster. This dude is not a left tackle. He's not a right tackle. He's not supposed to lock down somebody like a Nick Bosa or any other legit edge defender in the NFL. He gets straight armed, that inside gap is open, and it forces Baker to rush his throw. Now, the second problem I have with this is the coverage. Okay, this is going to be essentially a cover four look from the 49ers. Okay, and what we get at the top here is we get double post. Okay, now double post is a great look against cover two. Great look against cover two, right? Because this cornerback is going to be the flat defender. We're going to run double post with these two cats, and it's going to put this safety in a bind. And he has to pick between one of those posts and the other one's going to be open. But you can tell right now from the cornerback's hips and how he's dropping that this is not cover two. This is cover four, right? See how the cornerbacks drop. Baker takes the bait 100%. But at this point in the play, you should know this is cover four. I can't throw that double post. I have to hit my flat, right? I have to live to fight another down. He doesn't. He tries to force the deeper post and he gets picked off by Richard Sherman. So off of this, right, first thing is the protection. Second thing is the read by Baker. And you can blame it a little bit on the play call, I guess. And I understand that there's a run action on this, but that's not enough, right? You got to know that, hey, we're in the middle of this. To me, isn't a middle of the field shot play, right? This is a on the other side of the 40. Maybe you're inside your own. I mean, I guess it is inside their own 30, but maybe if you're on the opposing 40, this just to me isn't the time to run really a shot play like this, especially on first and 10, right? Running on second and short, so you can live to fight another down. All right, fellas, next play we're going to take a look at is a third down and 7 on the Browns' own 15. What I have a problem with on this play is the quarterback, number 6, right? We have to be able to identify a hot read, and we have to be able to hit that hot read and that blitz beater. Now, what we're going to get out of the Niners, and if you guys did watch my Niners breakdown, we're kind of going over things twice, but this is just too many, right? There's too many for the Browns to block. Okay, they're bringing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on this play. We end up getting 2 on here. Ideally, it's not too many for the Browns to block, okay? But what the Browns have to do if they're going to pick this up is they have to switch their slide protection, right? Right now, they're sliding to the left on this, and they're sliding away from the pressure. They have to slide it to the right. Now, they are bringing a defensive back from depth, and that is difficult to read, no doubt about it, right? That's tough to sit here and go pre-snap and say, yeah, this dude's coming. Okay, really, you're kind of taking your chances. It's a good job from the back of working all the way across the line of scrimmage and picking this up, but this dude's left free, and that guy's got to be for the quarterback, right? In your protections, you understand that, okay, yes, we have 5 offensive linemen. We have our 1 back. If we go max protect, then we have 2 guys in to help. But if there is ever a situation where you only have 1 back in, okay, and they bring 7, let's say, then you have 1 for the quarterback, and that's the quarterback's guy. Okay, now, yes, Baker is getting heat almost immediately. But with this route combination, right, we're going to get a deeper route from our number three, and our number two is running a drag across the field, right? We're basically getting like a dig and then a drag. Okay, your drag is your hot. You got to hit this as soon as you can if you're feeling heat. As soon as you can, right? And you have to know, okay, this, you have to see this pressure essentially, right? Yeah, if we're bringing one from this side, that's enough for me to say, okay, I'm going to try to hit my hot. All right, I have to hit my hot read right now. Yeah, they are dropping D Ford, but he drops a little too much. Not only that, but hey, throw it to your receiver and force this dude to make a play. All right, now it's a lot to process, okay? It's a lot to process really quickly. All right, but Baker Mayfield's a good quarterback. I've been a fan of his since he was at Oklahoma. I know he can get things like this done. This is a learning curve for him. But again, this is another one of those things. This is what's killing the Browns right now. It's the process of how they're working. It's the process of going through plays. It's the schematics of it that they're not hitting right now. I think it'll click eventually, but right now it's hurting them. All right, fellas, we have plays like the last one that are, in my opinion, are on Baker. And then we have plays like this one that's on the offensive line. Okay, watch our left tackle on this play. Very simple, empty protection. It's essentially going to be big on big. They ID the mic as 54, so that's why the center and the left guard are both looking this way. We have man on man on the backside, and we're pretty much locked up with this left tackle. Okay, now Nick Bosa does an excellent job of rushing upfield and then essentially using that pin swipe jump move that you've seen like Aaron Donald and Von Miller has been using it, right? They try to swipe the elbows of the offensive lineman, get their hips skinny, and get through this inside gap that's left between the left tackle and the left guard. Okay, great move by him. Horrible job by this left tackle. Horrible job by this left tackle. There's too much space that we're giving up here. In my opinion, there's too much space that we're giving up on the inside. Now, I understand that we have to, we really have to kick like that because Nick Bosa is so damn fast, right? But this is just a bad job by the tackle. He has to be able to at least redirect and do more than just kick a leg out like he does here. And I think that he would admit to that, right? We get a twist on the other side. This is really just pressure. Everything's bearing down on six. He's got no chance to get this thing off. So, you know, one of my skepticisms going into the season with the Browns was their offensive line and if Freddie Kitchens could get the job done. And right, Baker's a good quarterback. He can run this thing. I completely believe in Baker. Right, but he has to have the time and you have to give him the right process to work with. Right now he doesn't have the right process, his offensive line's bad, and stuff like this is happening. So this next play that we're taking a look at here against the Niners, you know, at this point in the game, it's a 14-0 game. If you get a score right here, we got ourselves a football game, we can go in, you know, it's almost the end of the first quarter in this, so the game's not away from you yet. You've moved the ball, time to go get some points and put this thing on your back, okay? I hate this play call. I'm going to be frank. I hate this play call. We're going to get a switch concept here at the bottom. All switches is 13 is going to run up this side of the field to the numbers outside in between the sideline and the numbers. 80 is going to run the opposite, right? He's going to run up. He's probably trying to get to the hash mark, and they're essentially going to try and shut it down in the end zone and try and find a space. Okay, on the back side of this, we're getting basically a post. We're going to get a flat out from our tight end here, and then we're going to get flat out from our back. All right, now, in the red zone, I've said this in almost every video I do, in the red zone, teams usually run cover two or man. That's what they do, okay? And this is inside the 15. You're probably going to get more man, either that or cover two. That's what you're going to get. That's football. That's just how it is, okay? We're getting essentially a cover. It's really like a cover three look, okay? Because Sherman's dropping back. We have this deep safety, and we have this deep safety, okay? What I don't like about this play call is that there is nothing attacking the middle of the field. We have nothing attacking the middle of the field, right? This flat defender over here, okay, he's probably just going to stay there, right? I understand leaking him out this way. I get that. I understand the idea of it, right? We're leaking our tight end out and we're leaking our back out because we want to hold flat defenders accountable. Right, we want to hold him accountable. We want to try and set up a good matchup for ourselves with these two receivers. We want to try and set up a good matchup for an isolated receiver. Okay, but we have to attack the middle of the field, especially in the red zone. Right? How often do you see great quarterbacks who hit their checkdown when they're inside the 20? Hit their checkdown when they're inside the 5? That's because everything is dropping off, and this middle of the field is a sweet spot that guys try to rally around to cover. In my opinion, with this play call, you have to have something, right? You have to leak your back out to a check down. And for all we know, right, he could have run this route wrong and he should be right here. Okay, that's entirely possible. But I'm going to guess that this isn't the first time the Niners have shown cover three on film inside the 10, right? Which, again, I don't like that call at all. I'm a loyalist in the sense of you run cover one or cover two in the red zone. But just nothing attacks the middle of the field on this, and I just think it's a bad play design. Like I said before, I understand it. But on top of that, look at the tackle play we're getting from our guys up front. Right, our right tackle is going to get smoked by D Ford on this play. How do you expect Baker to go and do something great with what he's got here? I mean, look at this. Our tackle is literally hopping and then crossing over to get to 55, breaking some cardinal rules. Never cross over. Never cross your feet. Never cross your feet like that. That is a recipe for disaster. You cross your feet, you're off balance, right? You can get pushed over easily. You're gonna fold like a house of cards. And I understand what D Ford's done here, right? That's partly because of his alignment. He's aligned in a jet alignment, and he's way out here, 2-point stance. My boy's pinning his ears back, and he's coming. But you can't kick out like that. You can't cross your feet. You have to kick out there, beat him to a point, sink your hips, and be ready for that next move. And again, I'm no O-line expert. This is just what I'm seeing wrong. But that's a horrible rep from 74. Got to be better. You're putting it all on six, and they actually almost get that thing done. All right, fellas, we're going to get a third down and seven here from the Browns on this play. Again, I like this play call. You know, the Browns are doing some good things. They're just not executing. What we're going to get out of this route combination-wise is we're going to get a deep out from number one. Number two is going to run a whip route to the sidelines, and number three is going to run a dig. All right, now, obviously, looking at Seattle, we've got one really deep safety, literally 20 yards off the ball, probably cover one. Right, if these corners were dropped off a little bit, it'd be cover three. Now this corner is dropped off, but that's because we have a bunch sort of formation down here, right? These three defensive backs are going to take care of these three receivers. Okay, but again, watch the execution on this. Decent job by the offensive line picking this thing up. Number one turns this thing into a speed out. He's got space to catch it. They just have to reel it in. These are the little things that are killing the Browns. All right, fellas, what we're going to get out of the Browns on this play is a really simple inside zone to the right look. All right, and you have the defense in exactly what you want them in. Okay, look at the backers that are in the box, right? We really only have one backer that's in the box. Okay, my left tackle is going to work down on 99, really just trying to wash him down the line of scrimmage. My left guard and my center are going to work a combo up from this one tech up to 54. We're working, I believe, out on this, out on 90, and then out on 50. Okay, and this thing plays up beautifully. This is outstanding. We're going to cut this thing back, crease this thing right up the middle, and probably get tackled around the five inside the three. Okay, but what happens here is my tackle doesn't do a good enough job on his inside zone step, and this thing gets shut down for a gain of one. All right, and the play from the tackles is one of the biggest things, in my opinion, that's killing the Browns right now. Look at my step on this. Solid job on the step, but we just have to be more firm with this backside hand. We can't get spun off. It's not even a spin. He just works his head across. We can't let stuff like this happen if you're an offensive tackle for the Browns, right? We have to be more physical with this double team because look at what we give up, man. This is a great call from the coaching staff, knowing what's going to happen on this, knowing the alignment that this defense is in. Bobby Wagner, one of the best in the NFL, is literally on the wrong side of the football, right? He should be filling on, well, not should be, but he is supposed to get across here and be filling on this. He totally bites on this play coming outside to the right or to the defense's left, but we can't give that up as a tackle. Because there's so much potential on this play, and points are so hard to get right now for Cleveland. It is a big play in this game. We have to be better at this left tackle spot from the Browns on this. All right, fellas, last play I'm taking a look at here in this Browns film breakdown. There's a couple of problems I have with this play. First things first, just to set the stage for you, it's second down and 10 on the Seattle 46. All right, the Browns are putting together a little bit of a drive. You need points in this situation. Right, you need points in every situation, but in this situation, I believe they're down and you need to score. Okay, so early in the second quarter. I can't stand this play call. Okay, we run a pick play on second down and 10, right? We're going to get a slant from number one. We're going to get a flat from number two. First off, like I said, I don't like the play call. But secondly, you have to hit this right if you're Baker. You have to see that we got to hit the flat on this. It's open. Even if you hang on to it for an extra second, hit that flat. right? We're creating this traffic right in the middle so that this dude has to work over the top to get there. You know, the reason why you're calling this play is because you know that this backer is going to be lined up on a back, and that's your mismatch. Let's hit it. Okay, so when I think about it like that, I don't hate this play call as much. But you have to be able to execute. This is very simple football that the Browns are messing up. All right, so again, I don't want to sit here and, you know, rag on the Browns. I'm just trying to shed a little bit of light for fans. All right, just that's all I'm trying to do. I take pride in being neutral as a football fan and enjoying the sport for what it is. I'm literally just trying to say, hey, this is what's going on from a fan perspective and from a coaching perspective. So with all that being said, guys, if I had to choose things that were wrong with the Browns right now, their tackle situation, their coaching and play calling, those are really their top two things that I have a problem with. So with all that being said, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope that you found it informative. If you did, please go ahead and drop that like, hit that subscribe button. You guys know I hate saying that, but it is helping me grow the channel. So that's all I got for you guys today. I'm the Hook Cam. I look forward to seeing you guys next time, and y'all have a good one.